carbon dioxide, or simply CO2, one of the most crucial elements needed for the health and growth of plants in planted tanks. It also helps with algae control, pH regulation, and many more. But which system is the best for your needs? What are the differences between those CO2 systems? And finally, which one should you buy? Today, I will show you all of my CO2 systems at the same time and walk you through all their strengths and weaknesses. Okay, these are almost all of my CO2 systems. Yes, I know it's a lot, but this is okay because you can see that I really tested a lot of them and I do have some experience. And second, you'll be able to clearly see the differences between them. We will discuss them in the order of complexity and price. Starting from the cheapest option, DIY CO2 reactor based on yeast. This method is by far the most budget-friendly. I made a detailed video about this solution quite some time ago, and if you're interested, there is a link to it in the description. It involves creating DIY CO2 generator that is using mixture of sugar, yeast, and water. As you can see, the entire system is really simple. You have a plastic bottle connected to a CO2 diffuser by an air pump tube. How it works? Is connected to the yeast that is consuming the sugar dissolved in water. Thanks to the perfect conditions for the yeast, it's starting to multiply itself and producing CO2 as side effect. It really is that simple. I was not using this system while creating this video, and I created this just to show you how it works, and it took me like 3 minutes. See those bubbles? This is CO2. There are few versions of this system. Most of them include additional bottle of water before the diffuser that acts as a safety feature and a filter. And sometimes people also include gelatin into the mix to make it last longer. The biggest advantage of these systems are, first of all, cost. Yeast, sugar, and bottle are super cheap, and you probably have them already in your house. So the only cost is actually the diffuser itself. But if you go for some cheap one, you can create this system for like 10 euros. Second advantage is that it lasts surprisingly long. With proper ratio of products in the mix, I was always able to get around 5 to 6 weeks of CO2 for 30-liter tank. It's obviously lower numbers than high-pressure system, but remember that we are talking about something that costs like 10 euros. And third advantage, I think it's a perfect system to start with CO2 and simply test what it's all about. So, if you are not sure if you see the benefits of CO2 in your tank, and hesitating before spending a lot of money, this could be the perfect temporary solution for you. But this kind of system also comes with few disadvantages. First of all, there is no way of regulating it. Meaning that once the mixture is done, CO2 will be produced at a certain speed, and there is nothing you can do about it. This is why it's important to use proper amount of yeast from the very beginning. The more yeast you use, the faster the reaction will be. It will create much more CO2, but of course the entire system will last for a significantly shorter period of time. Second problem is that you cannot shut it down overnight. This system is not designed to contain very high pressures. So using solenoid is out of the question. Pressure buildup overnight would be too big and entire system might just break apart. And lastly, this system is not very stable. Yeast activity is highly dependent on the temperature. It produces CO2 much faster when it's warm and slows down once the temperature drops. This might lead to some pH and CO2 fluctuations in your tank. So, in my opinion, that system is the best for very small tanks, people that would like to use CO2 with minimal cost, and people that would like to try CO2 for the first time and are not sure about bigger investment. Second option that I used is pressurized CO2 reactor based on citric acid. This one is the second in line when it comes to cost. You may think about it as a turbocharged version of the previous one, because this system also creates CO2 from generally available ingredients: water, citric acid, and baking soda. Only this system is made from much stronger materials and can handle much higher pressures. And because of that, it has a lot of benefits previously available only in most expensive options. As you can see, I can have solenoid attached to it, you can include precision valve, bubble counter, and so on. I got it for like 70 euros, and I think that it's really good price considering that it already had everything included. Yes, this is much more expensive than the previous option, but you do get much more for your money. And the quality jump is really big. In fact, I like it so much that I bought a second one, so this should tell you something. Regarding benefits, first of all, you have full control over the amount of CO2 that you are dosing to your tank. Because of the precision valve, you can set any number of bubbles per second. There is no risk of accidental overdosing, and after you make it running, it works just like the high pressure system. Second, solenoid. Possibility of switching it off during the night is not only much better for the fish and your plants, but you save a lot of CO2. This is because you can use it when it's really needed. So, for example, only for 8 hours a day instead of unnecessary 24. And third, you don't have to take it anywhere to refill it. And you will know when it's getting empty based on the pressure gauge. I like the fact that I don't have to rely on any outside factors, and I can refill it in just a few minutes. But of course, this system is not perfect, and it also has some drawbacks. First of all, it's not suitable for bigger tanks. Even though you have full control over it, you cannot realistically use it in a heavily planted tank bigger than, let's say, 100 liters. You would have to refill it frequently, and after a while, it might not be cost effective. And second, filling it up might be problematic for inexperienced users. The reaction of ingredients is very, very fast at the beginning. And after you mix all of them, you really have to act fast and close the cylinder quickly. It might make some people nervous, and if you are not quick enough, it might get a little dirty. Overall, in my opinion, that system is best for small to medium tanks, people that want to start the journey with CO2 for a reasonable price, people that want to refill their system at home. And now we are moving to the ultimate option, which is pressurized CO2 system. This is definitely the most expensive option on the list. And again, I have two of them. This one can handle 1.5 kilograms of CO2, and the big one is 3.3 kilograms. So yeah, that's a lot of CO2. Of course, both those systems have solenoids attached to them. This time, obviously there is no DIY, but just pure CO2 that you get in the cylinder. When it comes to benefits, first of all, it's the most stable and reliable system. External factors like temperature don't affect it at all. Second, you have full control over it. You can regulate the speed, switch it off at night, and attach it even to the biggest diffuser, if you wish. And lastly, this is by far the biggest system, and therefore it lasts very long. We are talking months for a tank of that size. And this is something that you will never get from DIY systems. But don't think that those systems come without any problems. And biggest one is obviously the cost. This will always be the most expensive option, and initial investments might be a little big. Prices are very different depending on the brand and size of the cylinder. But you should assume the cost starting from around 160 to 180 euro for the smaller one. Second problem is that the refilling is really problematic. And this is something that I really hate. To refill it, you need to disconnect everything, take it to the proper place or store that will actually do it. And this is really not that obvious in some areas. So check it out before you buy. And the last problem on my list is that those systems can be very big and quite heavy. It's a smaller problem, but you should be aware that you need to plan for it if you're gonna get a bigger one like this one. Overall, in my opinion, this system is the best for bigger tanks. This is basically the only option if you have like 200 liter heavily planted tank. People that have the budget for good CO2 system. People with easy access to CO2 filling stations. To summarize, CO2 is no longer only for the rich. You can find something that suits your needs without any problems. Based on my experience with many different systems, if you are really new to this, I would suggest to try one DIY system based on yeast. If you like it, if you see the benefits of CO2, you can decide what to do next. Right now I'm really enjoying this one, citric acid based system, because I think it's a great compromise and just perfect for the tanks around 40 to 50 liters. I like it so much that I found myself not using this one anymore for my smaller tanks. Let me know in the comments if you are already using CO2 system, and if yes, what kind?